Welcome to The Climate Crisis, addressing five key areas for change. This lesson is food. In this lesson, we'll examine how climate change is affecting agriculture and food security. We'll also look at examples of innovative solutions being implemented in local communities to mitigate and adapt to climate challenges. This lesson is written by Caitlin Welsh, Director of the Global Food Security Program at the Center for Strategic and International Studies. She has served as Acting Director in the Department of State's Office of Global Food Security, where she analyzed global food security and its relationship to climate change, conflict, and urbanization. She is a former Peace Corps volunteer. Welsh writes that agriculture and food systems generate 31% of the total greenhouse gas emissions from human activities, a 17% increase since 1990. Climate change is also making it harder to produce food and get it to consumers because of extreme weather events, irregular rainfall, agricultural pests, plant diseases, and other factors. At the same time, according to the United Nations, around 31% of food produced globally is lost or wasted each year, squandering resources and generating additional greenhouse gas emissions when the food decomposes. All of this affects food security and nutrition around the world, in rural and urban areas. Climate variability can influence all dimensions of food security. It can reduce crop yields and increase the incidence of pests that destroy crops. It can diminish households' ability to afford food by reducing their incomes. It can decrease the nutritional content of crops and increase rates of diarrheal illnesses and other diseases that can cause malnutrition. And it can lead to sudden spikes in food prices. Therefore, Welsh says, it is important to consider the implications of climate change on food security in urban areas as well as rural areas, and to consider implications for health and livelihoods in addition to decreased food production. Welsh notes that there are opportunities for young leaders to help solve these problems across the entire food value chain, from farm production to transportation and storage, to connecting retailers with consumers, using both climate mitigation and adaptation strategies. Mitigation strategies focus on reducing greenhouse gas emissions and protecting the natural environment, while adaptation strategies adjust to the effects of climate change. When looking for solutions within your own community, Welsh says it is important to consider what challenges exist in your unique context, and then think of ways you could help to fill those gaps. These solutions can often produce new income streams for you and your community, which can help families grow and afford more nutritious food. For example, a lowland region of Nepal was experiencing flooding due to climate change. Community members used bioengineering to build small water breaks out of bamboo and rocks. This slowed the flow of water and reduced soil erosion, creating new land for growing crops like sugarcane that provide extra income. In another example, a project called Africa Sand Dam Foundation identified droughts as a major challenge for farmers and communities in rural Kenya. To address this, they constructed concrete walls, called sand dams, across seasonal river channels to store water under the sand, increasing the availability of water year-round and regenerating the surrounding environment. In El Salvador, climate change is disrupting rainfall patterns and making it harder for farmers to grow traditional crops like maize. By incorporating agroforestry, planting trees within farms, farmers have increased maize yields, earned extra income from growing cacao trees and producing chocolate, and improved long-term soil fertility. Further down the supply chain, a young man in Nairobi, Kenya, discovered that his local grocery vendor could only store food for about 2 to 3 days before it went bad. So he created Freshbox, a solar-powered food cooling room where retailers can store perishable products to increase their shelf life and reduce food waste, reducing greenhouse gas emissions and also increasing food availability and retailers' income. These are just a few examples that Welsh shares of ways in which young leaders can use climate change mitigation and adaptation to improve food security in their communities. It will look different in each place. You are the experts on the biggest climate threats in your own region. You can put your unique skills to work to address the challenges you identified, using creative ideas and technologies to improve food security and community resilience. For more on this course and to access related resources, visit our website.